Now we are discussing about business communication, its process, importance, type and barriers. It is a part of marketing management of MBA 108. Communication. Communication is fundamental to the existence and survival of human as well as to an organization. It is a process of creating and sharing ideas, information, views, facts, feelings, etc. Among the people to reach a common understanding. Communication is the key to the directing function of management. A manager may be highly qualified and skilled, but if he does not possess good communication skill, all his ability become irrelevant. A manager must communicate his directions effectively to the subordinates to get the work done from them properly. Communication process. Communication is a continuous process which mainly involves three elements: sender, message, and receiver. The elements involved in the communication process. Now, we can discuss on it. The number one is sender, second, message, third one is encoding, fourth, media, fifth, decoding, receiver, feedback, and noise. The first point is sender. The sender of the communicator generates the message and convey it to the receiver. He is the source and the one who start the communication. Second one is message. It is the idea, information, view, fact, feeling, etc. that is generated by the sender and is then intended to be communicated further. Encoding. The message generated by the sender is encoded symbolically, such as in the form of words, picture, gesture, etc. before it is being conveyed. Fourth number is media. It is the manner in which the encoded message is transmitted. The message may be transmitted orally or in writing. The medium of communication includes telephone, internet, post, fax, email, etc. The choice of medium is decided by the sender. Now, there are many other media is also available through WhatsApp messages, through Messenger, to social media messages. There are many other medias. Nowadays, they are introduced. Fifth one is decoding. It is the process of converting the symbols encoded by the sender after decoding the message is received by the receiver. Sixth one is receiver. He is the person who is last in the chain and for whom the message was sent by the sender. Once the receiver receives the message and understands it in proper perspective and acts according to the message, only then the purpose of communication is successful. Seventh is feedback. It is very essential for completing the communication process. Once the receiver confirms to the sender that he has received the message and understood it, the process of communication is complete. The last one is noise. it refers to any obstructions that is caused by the sender, message or receiver during the process of communication. For example, bad telephone connections, low connectivity, faulty encoding, faulty decodings, attentive receiver, poor understanding of message due to prejudice or inappropriate gesture. They are the some of the examples we have discussed. Now, we are talking about importance of communication. He is the basis of coordination, fluent working, the basis of decision making, increases managerial efficiency, increases cooperation and organizational peace, boosts morale of the employees. The first is the basis of coordination. The manager explains to the employees the organization goals, modes of their achievement and also the interpersonal relationship amongst them. This provides coordination between various employees and also departments. Thus, communication acts as a basis for coordination in the organization. Second is fluent working. A manager coordinates the human and physical elements of an organization to run it smoothly and efficiently. This coordination is not possible without proper communication. Third one is the basis of decision making. Proper communication provides information to the manager that is useful for decision making. No decisions could be taken in the absence of information. Thus, communication is the basis for taking the right decisions. Fourth, increased manager efficiency. The manager conveys the target and issues instructions and allocates jobs to the subordinates. All of these aspects involve communication. Thus, communication is essential for the quick and effective performance to the manager and the entire organization. Fifth one is increased cooperation and organizational peace. The two-way communication process promotes cooperation and mutual understanding amongst the workers and also between them and the management. This leads to less friction and those leads to the industrial peace in the factory and efficient operations. Sixth one is boost morale of the employees. Good communications helps the workers to adjust to the physical and social aspects of work. It also improves good human relations in the industry. An efficient system of communication enables the management to motivate, influence and satisfy the subordinates, which in turn boosts their morale and keep them motivated. Type of communication. In general, there are two types of communication: formal communication and informal communication. In the formal communication have the two parts, vertical communication and horizontal communication. And there are the some types of communication network: informal communication, this is single chain communication, wheel communication, circular, free flow and inverted V communication. The first stage, formal communication. Formal communication are the one which flow through the official channel design in the organizational chart. It may take place between a superior and a subordinate. A subordinate and a superior or among the same cadre, employees or managers. These communication can be oral or in writing and are generally recorded and filed in the office. Formal communication may be further classified as vertical communication and horizontal communication. Vertical communication is the name suggests flow vertical upward or downwards through formal channels. Upward communication refers to the flow of communication from a subordinate to a superior, whereas downward communication flow from a superior to a subordinate. Application for grant of leave, submission of a progress report, request for loan, etc. are some of the examples of upward communication. Sending notice to employees to attend a meeting, delegating work to the subordinates, informing them about the company policies, etc. are some of the examples of downward communication. Second, horizontal communication. Horizontal or lateral communication takes place between one division and another. For example, a production manager may contact the finance manager to discuss the delivery of raw material or its purchase is the one of the example of horizontal communication. There are type of communication network: informal communication, single chain. In this type of network, communications flow from every superior to his subordinate through a single chain. In this network, all subordinates under one superior communicate through him only. They are not allowed to talk amongst themselves. Circular. In this type of network, the communication moves in a circle. Each person is able to communicate with the adjoining two persons only. Free flow. In this network, each person can communicate with any other person freely. There is no restrictions. Inverted V. In this type of network, a subordinate is allowed to communicate with his immediate superior as well as his superior also. However, in the later case, only ordinated communications take place. Second is informal communication. Any communication and that take place without following the formal channels of communication is said to be an informal communication. The informal communication is often referred to as the repavin, as it separates throughout the organization and in all directions without any regards to the level of authority. The informal communication spreads rapidly, often gets destroyed, and it is very difficult to detect the source of such communication. It also leads to rumors which are not true. People's behavior is often affected by the rumors and informal discussions, which sometimes may hamper the work environment. However, sometimes these channels may be helpful as they carry information rapidly and therefore may be useful to the manager at time. Informal channels are also used by the managers to transmit information in order to know the reactions of his or her subordinates. Now, type of repavin network. In type of repavin network, first we discuss single stand. In this network, each person communicated with the other in a sequence. Gossip network. In this type of network, each person communicated with all other person on a non-selective basis. Probability network. In this network, the individual communicates randomly with other individuals. Cluster network. In this network, the individual communicates with only those people whom he trusts. Out of these four types of network, the cluster network is the most popular in organization. There are some barriers in communication. Barriers to communication. The communication barriers may prevent communication or carry incorrect meaning due to which misunderstanding may be created. Therefore, it is essential for a manager to identify such barriers and take appropriate measures to overcome them. The barriers to communication in organization can be broadly grouped as follows. First is semantic barriers. These are concerned with the problems and obstructions in the process of encoding and decoding of a message into word or impressions. Normally, such barriers result due to use of wrong words, faulty translations, different interpretations, etc. For example, a manager has to communicate with workers who have no knowledge of the English language, and on the other side, he is not well conversant with the Hindi language. Here, language is a barrier of communication, as the manager may not be able to communicate properly with the workers. In psychological barriers, emotional or psychological factors also act as a barrier of communication. The set of mind of both sender and receiver of communication reflect in effective communication. A worried person cannot communicate properly, and an angry recipient cannot understand the message properly. Thus, at a time of communication, both the sender and the receiver need to be psychologically sound. Also, they should trust each other. If they don't believe each other, they cannot understand each other's message in its original sense. Third is organizational barriers. The factors related to organizational structures, rules and regulations, authority relationships, etc. may sometimes act as a barrier of effective communication. In an organization with a highly centralized pattern, people may not be encouraged to have free communications. Also, rigid rules and regulation and cumbersome processor may also become a hurdle to communication. Personal barriers. The personal factors of both sender and receiver may act as a barrier of effective communication. If a superior thinks that a particular communication may adversely affect his authority, he may suppress such communication. Also, if the superior do not have confidence in the competency of their subordinates, they may not ask for their advice. The subordinates may not be willing to offer useful suggestion in the absence of any reward or appreciation for a good suggestions. Thank you very much.